Dani, com es veu, el treball és complex. Sé que és difícil segurament seguir aquesta impressionant quantitat de dades, però en canvi ens semblava que era interessant que veiéssiu la complexitat que significa abordar aquesta, que no és un problema que es pugui abordar des de la simplificació o des d'una resposta molt ràpida. I sobretot que el treball de diagnosi és un treball absolutament imprescindible i aquest treball de diagnosi s'ha de fer rigorós i curós. Si no, tenim tendència a simplificar molt el problema i per tant no abordar i no destinar els diners allà on toca. Aquest seria una mica la, diguéssim, el corol·lari final, no? En aquest sentit. Bé, la tercera ponència és l'amic, ens ve de Bèlgica, el Joris Beaumon. Joris Beaumon, ho he dit bé, sí? Ens explicarà la seva experiència en el municipi de Ghent i esperem que sigui igualment profitosa. Al teu torn, gràcies.
Okay, ready for one more before lunch. I'm Joris from the Public Center for Social Welfare, Ghent. That is a local authority providing social services in Ghent. I think some of you might know. Good, not. Some of you might know our city. I was very jealous yesterday of the people from Utrecht that had a nice little film. I might ask my organization to make one of those. But to make a little to give you some information about our city. It's the second largest city in the Flemish-speaking part of Belgium. We have approximately 255,000 inhabitants. It is a medieval city, and that translates itself in the housing quality at this moment still. There is a really poor housing quality in the center of the city, so we will talk about this later on. But what is very important that Ghent is since 20 years a really rapidly growing city. We are now 255,000 inhabitants, but if you see the red line, there's a prognosis till 2030 we will be with 270,000 people. And that is a problem because the housing market is not following in the same tempo as the inhabitants themselves. Some more information, there are 120,000 households at this moment, and important is to see that there, half of them are single persons or single parents. So there is a difference, there's a change in household types during the years. There are a lot of more people living apart, so there is a need for more housing. The average family size at this moment is 2.18, so that's not very large families. I go to this slide first. Some more information, European poverty rate for Belgium 15.5%, for Flanders 9.8%. So we do a little bit better than the Wallonie, the French-speaking part of Belgium. But for me, as I'm responsible for poverty reduction in Ghent, so this figure is quite important. We have, if we look at the births in Ghent, one out of four almost is a birth in a poor or vulnerable family, and that's quite a dangerous figure as I see it. One back. There is another part, another reason that there is extra pressure on the housing market, and that is because we are a student city, there is a big university in Ghent. That means that there are 75,000 students in Ghent, of which are 30,000 really living in Ghent as well. So that's an immense extra pressure on the housing market. We have almost 100,000 people coming to work in Ghent. Some of them stay once in a while in Ghent, so that's an extra element. Tourism as well, we are very glad there are a lot of tourists, but that's another extra pressure. Concerning housing, at this moment, one in two households pay more than one-third of their income on fixed housing. When I started as a social worker 15 years ago, I always told my clients, be sure if you rent something, to not go above one-third of your income, because you might get into dangerous situations. later on. And now we see that one out of two already above this figure. A lot of people pay more than half and even more of their income to only to the fixed housing costs, not even electricity. 43% of rental housing is in a very poor state. That's what I meant in the beginning with the medieval character. It's an old city. It's there's a 19th century belt of around the city with really poor housing state. And social housing, I think it's quite less than in Liverpool or in England. We have 10,500 households waiting on social housing, and the waiting list goes up to more than 10 years. So that's quite another problem. So now I want to focus on some local policies, how we try to attack these kind of problems. I talk about two units in our own organization, but I think most important, there's one new project, and I want to finish my presentation with this. It's called Dampoort Knapt Op. It's one neighborhood that has been part of a new project where we look at a new target group and found a new way of financing renovation within one neighborhood. But first, the energy unit of our own organization, it's a quite small unit, 8 social workers, but they have an integrated approach on 4 areas. First of all, operational aid. We really try to avoid people being cut off of energy, water, and gas supply. Once there are a lot of commercial suppliers in Belgium. Once you stop paying or have a debt with one of those commercial suppliers, you're being dropped there and you go to the social supplier. That's called EANDIS. But once you have difficulties paying your bills with the Andes, they have the right as well to cut off your electricity or gas, but they send us monthly invoices, lists of people who are in that situation. So we contact every one of them to see if we can arrange something, to see if we can place a budget meter or do some mediation to make sure that they don't that they are not being cut off. That's one very operational part of the approach. Of course, we give some financial aid as well. People with energy debt can be relieved. We pay some of them of their debts, and then we try to make an obligation of result. They have to come to us to every month to make sure that the bills are paid, and then we can take further arrangements. We have a lot of own measures, but also federal measures. You know that we have a very complex state structure in Belgium. Every type of this, every part of the structure has different type of measures. So we try to arrange that our people really know all the different type of measures and can use them. Third one, methodological support, searching for premiums, searching for social rights, making up balanced budget plans, and that's real kind of methodological support to make sure that our clients can be strong enough to take care of themselves. And fourth but not least, of course, a preventive approach. That's changing the behavior of our clients. That's the most important part, of course, and working to the future. We do energy scans, we give them interest-free loans to arrange their houses. We talk to owners, not, of course not to renters, but owners have to fix the houses. We help them to get the interest-free loan to arrange their own houses to rent to our clients and so on and so on. So that's the energy unit. We have a housing unit as well. It's a bit bigger team, 12 social workers. Two important parts. First of all, housing counseling. I can imagine you are acquainted with the housing first principles. So we have a 50 type reserved places in social housing. When we know people in the street, that want to take a next step, we can give them these reserved places to stabilize their living conditions. We think it's important first to give them a stable housing, and after maybe 1 year, maybe never, it's time to take next steps into other life domains, but it depends on the clients themselves if they want to take those steps, and we really need an intensive tailor-made process for this. It's a very, very good approach because 86% of those people who used to be homeless still live in these houses after a lot of time. We see that other projects with homeless people have really less results. And the second part, housing mediation, that's something we do for the whole of the city. That means that when people are behind with their payments in social and in private renting, we as a local government do the mediation with the owner. We always are contacted by the government if somebody is in a procedure of expulsion. And then we do everything we can to avoid the real expulsion. So, these were a few strategies we do from our own organization. I think it's good now to look at one specific project. It's something we started about a year ago. It's called Dampoort Knaptop. Dampoort is the name of the neighborhood, and Knaptop means revives it, fixes it, renovates it. It's so, as I mentioned in the first part of the presentation, there's a lot of pressure on the housing market. That means that the renting prices are really, really high. And we see a new tendency that people make a decision not to rent anymore because it goes from himself. People are doubting if they should rent some more, or maybe even better, try and buy a house and try to renovate it. So they look at the poor segment of the housing and try and buy a house. But we have a new name for it. We call it emergency buyers, because I think it's best to make sure that you have a house instead of paying every month 500, 600, 700 euros, you can take a loan and buy a house for yourself. But of course, a problem is then the quality of the housing. That's one thing. The impact on health is incredible. I don't have to tell you people about this. When these people buy a house, there is not much money left to make some renovations. People are not really into looking about all the information. What can we do about renovation? Which premiums are existing? What can we do? So most of these people, those emergency buyers, never tend to renovate their houses and have the impact on their health. So we started a new project with what we call a rolling fund. So we give those people a loan, and specifically 30,000 euros each. They don't receive the money themselves, but the money is being used to make renovation in these houses. And the extra value that is being created by this renovation comes back to the fund. So the people pay back the fund, the 30,000 euro, when they move, when they sell their house. And if there is extra value, a part of this extra value is coming back to the fund as well. So this means the investment of the local government in this system is always a winning situation, because the money still every time comes back and with an extra value. So it's even a growing fund. And the growing fund is every time being reinvested in new people. It's quite a simple idea, I think. Maybe it's already existing in other countries, but in Flanders it's really a new idea. So we started up in one neighborhood with only 300,000 euros. We selected 10 families, 10 houses, in very bad shape. And we attracted the whole neighborhood. It was really a process of attracting all stakeholders and discussions. to select the worst houses and the best families to take part of this project. So more information about the project themselves. It's a cooperation between local authority, one building organization that takes part of everything. So maybe you people have renovated yourself. One of the problems, of course, is that you have to talk with a lot of different people who are doing the roof, who are doing the glass and all different things. Vulnerable people are not strong, most of the time not strong enough to have all these contacts. So now we work with one building organization that takes care of the whole process of renovation. That's really unburdening for the people involved. So there are different social organizations working on an individual level and on the community level. So the whole of the community in this neighborhood is being involved. Target group, as I mentioned, emergency buyers with a limited income living in poor living conditions. Because it's a pilot project, we selected one block in one neighborhood to try it out and see what the results will be. So the support these people get is, in the first hand, socially, of course, but also building technically, because we have a really good cooperation with this building company. It's called Domus Mundi. They know all the details and know what has to be done. And the people get support before, during, and after the process of renovation. That is a really important topic. These people need to be really unburdened, really be supported in the whole trajectory. And of course, one other part is the exhaustion of premiums. As I mentioned before, there are a lot of premiums and possibilities, social rights in Belgium, but it's really, really hard to know what you have to go ask where and which papers you have to make in order and things like that. So some of the first results. The quality of the housing. If you sell a house, it has to be screened in Flanders. Maybe there's a similar system here, and you get penalty points for weaknesses. If we see in this project before we started, the average of the housing was 54.5 penalty points, and afterwards it was 11.3. And we think there's still some more potential if we do all the renovation that we first had in mind and didn't have any problems during the way, we could land on 5.8 penalty points. That is a really huge difference for the quality of these housing. Energy level, before and after. When you sell a house, you have to make an energy audit and the energy level of the house. Before we started, that's the red part. The quality of the energy level was really poor, and afterwards we made half of the progress. So now it's on 250. And one important part as well is the received premiums, because we really focused on attracting all the specific premiums those people are entitled to. On the budget of 300,000 euros, we gained also 82,000 extra premiums. That means that on top of the 30,000 euros every family got, they also received almost 10,000 euros on premiums and social rights. So that's an extra they could use in the renovation. So in this project, what we found out, what works is the combination of a collective approach, attracting the neighborhood, involving the neighborhood, doing these things together on the one hand, and the individual approach on the other hand, really supporting those people during the entire process. But not only socially, but also building technically. That's a very, very important combination. And of course, we found that people who are being involved in this project really were activated. They were really more and more involved in the project, really more and more active in searching themselves, doing things themselves, not letting everything being done by the building company, but they really picked up the trajectory. Specific target group, we really believe that we have to keep on focusing on this target group. It's a new group. and it's a group we really have to support because, as we mentioned yesterday, neighborhood renovation tends to get the side effect that the weak people move out of these neighborhoods, and this is a good approach to keep those people in the same neighborhood. So it's a win-win situation. Of course, what works is the link between quality of housing, energy, saving, health, it's all hanging together. And this new type of funding, what we call retention fund, is really paying off. And as I mentioned before, it's a win-win situation in this case because the local government who puts this money the first time is sure that this money keeps being invested. It's not a loss for the community. Now we're in the stage of, we did a first evaluation and are looking into upscaling the fund and upscaling the project as a one part and upscaling the fund, of course, as well. Diversifying the approach, of course, because we saw in these 10 renovations that there are always unforeseen events that we have to change and tackle at the moment itself. We have discussions now with the Flemish Minister for for Poverty Reduction. This could be a good practice that she wants to, Minister Humans wants to involve in her poverty plan for Flanders. And we are still looking now as well for private funding to make it a public-private cooperation and always looking for new partners to have some more impact in our city. So that's in one short overview, this specific project. There's a lot of broader involvement of stakeholders, but I prefer today to focus on one project. Maybe it could be interesting for your own cities. Thank you.